Hello, and welcome to Public Works TV. My name is John Thomas, and I'm San Francisco's City Engineer and Deputy Director for Infrastructure Design and Construction. Before we get started, let's take a look back at some of our accomplishments this week.
60 students from the San Francisco Public Montessori School helped clean up the Pacific Heights neighborhood. The city kicked off the holiday season with its annual tree lighting at Civic Center Plaza. We visited 12 Days of Kittens, a holiday adoption event held by Supervisor Katie Tang's office. Stay tuned for more info.
Let's talk about paving. So San Francisco has over 12,000 blocks. We have been paving on average now over 600 blocks per year. Every street is checked annually. Streets are evaluated on a scale of 1 to 100, and that's referred to as a pavement condition index, with 100 being in the best condition, as if it was just paved. The streets need to be repaved between 40 and 60. So if you think about a typical street cross-section, we have all of the utilities that service the buildings, the residences, the businesses along that street. As you move up, we build a concrete base which supports the roadway. In general, it's around 8 to 10 inches thick. And on top of that, we place 2 to 3 inches of asphalt that is the wearing surface that the vehicles ride on. Traffic contributes to where the constant repetitive vibration will wear and tear on a given street. We expect that our streets will last between 30 and 50 years, and many of them have been in place for far longer. So we focus on keeping the streets that are in okay condition, in that condition or better, rather than spending all of the money on an annual basis on the worst streets. To give you an example, to do a micro-surfacing project, which will extend the life of that street for 5 and 7 years, we might spend $10,000. To do a grind and pave project, it might cost $60,000. But to do a reconstruction, it can cost as much as $400,000 to $500,000. So once a street has fallen into that state of disrepair, that cost, which is between 10 and 30 times as expensive as the other repairs that I mentioned, means that we'll do that many fewer blocks. And once that begins to happen, if we spend more money on the worst blocks, then more and more blocks will continue to deteriorate to the point where our backlog will grow exponentially. Now, that isn't to say that they're ignored. We do pothole repair, and then every year we do complete reconstruction for somewhere between 20 and 30 blocks. We coordinate with the SFMTA and the SFPUC to make sure that if a water line or sewer line or both need to be replaced, that they are done at the same time as we're doing the infrastructure improvements to the roadway. In doing so, we minimize the disruption to the neighborhood and have that done just once. And then when we're done, that street should be in great shape for the next 30 years plus. And all of our paving projects include upgrading all of the curb ramps wherever it is that we're working and making sure that they are in compliance with the most current ADA standards. We're kind of at a crossroads with our infrastructure in the sense that this is a once in a several generation point in time that we find ourselves. Our city is well over 150 years old now. Much of our infrastructure is in excess of 100 years old. And by infrastructure, I'm generally referring to the sewer and water systems below the ground, and they require replacement. It's most opportune to do that when we're doing a paving project. So it extends the duration of our construction, but once that's in place, they're going to be good for another 100 years. So I think that's one of the things that we don't often convey to the residents of the city, but which is of utmost importance. Well, I hope I was able to answer some questions you may have had about paving today. If you'd like to learn more, visit our website and follow us on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram. I'm John Thomas. Thanks for tuning in to Public Works TV.